The Steelers' wild and wintry game ended in an NFL first with an 11-10 win for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And the big man to bring home the W was our very own Jeff Reed. Jeff, an amazing final kick. Congratulations.
Thank you. I tell you what, it doesn't get any easier. You know, you feel like if you hit one every once in a while for a game winner, it gets easier, but it definitely doesn't.
Okay, a couple of controversial plays on Sunday. The first 51-yarder.
Yeah, you know, I missed whoever said, woo. But, no, it was one of those, it was my fault. I wasn't fully warmed up for it. On a cold day, I should have been warming up into the net. But I figured if it was fourth down in that situation, because there's been some warmer games where he hasn't even gone for a 50-plus yarder. So yeah, I thought he was going to play field position because we knew, in those kind of conditions, it was going to be a tight game. But, you know, they have confidence in me, and I should have been ready, so that's my fault. And, you know, that's what happens when you're not ready.
Well, Coach Tomlin actually has you guys prepare for those wintry conditions. I remember talking to you far before the season even started about Coach Tomlin making it colder in the training facility than it is outside.
I'll tell you what, there was nothing worse than Coach Cowher, though. Coach Tomlin, I don't think he really likes being cold either. He doesn't admit it, but, I kind of like his style because it is kind of chilly. Opens the doors up when we're inside, but Coach Cowher, literally, it'd be 25 degrees outside. He'd turn the fans on full blast. I mean, it would be colder inside than outside. You know, only thing missing was the wind chill. But other than that, those balls did not travel inside either.
Okay, well, the second controversial play that has been heard around the league is the touchdown that was taken back at the end of the game. The NFL has come out and said that it was a mistake. It should have been a touchdown. As a player, does that bother you? Does it stay with you? How do you feel about it?
Either way, as long as we win the game, that's all that really matters. But at the same time, you know, that's against the defensive stats, and that's against Troy's stats. And so, you know, hats off to those guys for finishing the game the way they did. But, you know, referees are human, so you kind of have to give them, although yesterday was kind of crazy. But, you know, we found a way to win. That's all that's really important because, you know, when you have 12, 13 penalties to one or two, most likely the team with the 12 or 13 is going to lose the game. So I'm glad we came out on top. And it's just, I think it's human error. You can, put that credit on.
Okay, now, Jeff, something funny happened to you right after the game. Somebody made it out to the field to you before the players were even on the field at the end of the game. Local radio station, you want to share with everyone?
Yes. if you listen to me, I do Tuesday morning sometimes on B94 morning show. Well, Bubba, who is one of the guys on there, he always says, if I ever get a chance to get a game win, I'll be the first guy out there. And I'm always like, yeah, whatever. They won't even let you on the field. Well, he was the first guy. You know, I was still celebrating, and he had a microphone in my mouth. So hats off to Bubba for getting on TV. But he did his job.
Well, they were kind of excited because they've been kind of running this campaign about Jeff going to Pro Bowl. So we want to encourage our fans, too, to vote for Jeff to go to Pro Bowl. But stay right there. We're coming right back. Go vote.